Welcome back to Let's Play A Tear of Vermillion Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Now leaving the Sorcery School with our new team member, Elenoa. Heading back to the village of Koruna, I believe it is, where Rael is, so Elenoa can help him translate this mysterious red book we found in the Ice Palace. Elenoa's goal is to bring Rael back to the Sorcery School. I want to check out her spells and stuff. Alright. Let's get rid of the bee. She uses a mace, I think. She uses a spirit. Oh wow, he just killed that right off. Alright, let's do wait. Oh, we can move him. We can move people and have them wait there. I didn't know that. Because I want to do the spirit magic, spirit undyne. For all enemies. That's cool. Something nurture, life, stuff. Go by so quick. That's pretty awesome. So she is level 14. Even a mile, barely 16. That's right, I wanted them to level up. We're heading this way, I think. Oh, is this the way of the school? Wait a second. No, because there's a monster here. We will have fought that. I want to see what she says, though. Angry pet, nice. Boom. Ah, it's not even worth it. Okay. Too easy this time. I wonder how long she'll be with us. Okay. I'm gonna go wait. And wait. And let's try this. Magic. I'll keep an eye on what she says this time. Those nurture life, answer me and show yourself. The bee remains. Alright, that's cool. That's the only spell she knows, by the way, but I don't mind because it's pretty powerful. Back on the Anil Highway. A man's voice says, "Hey there." Miles says, "Hey, you're a friend of Douglas." "Ah, I remember you, Babyface." "Don't call me Babyface," Max says. "Anyway, didn't you just come from the Sorcery School?" "Yeah, so?" "I heard about the Siam Seal Gang. The president of the Sorcery School asked me to guard the school, and I accepted the job. Can you tell me anything about useful about the attack of the Siam Seal Gang?" "So you accepted the job," Even says. "They briefed Adventurer Max on what had happened." "Okay, I got it. My instincts tell me that the Siam Seal Gang probably won't come back. But I'll stay there for a while, just to make sure." "Thank you," says Elenoa. "Please watch over the school." "Okay, leave it to me. I, Babyface Max, will protect the Sorcery School with my life." "Thought you didn't want us to call you that." "Okay, I must be going." Avon says, "He has a baby face, but his skills tell me he's a professional adventurer." Miles says he is Douglas's friends. After all, how many friends is he? It looks like just one person. I think we can count on him, Elenoa says. Now, I got a tip that I should just follow him and talk to him at the school. I don't know if it has to be now, but I'm going to do it just in case. It's not too far. I'm not going to try not to run into any monsters here. They don't feel like fighting us anyway. Just let us get past you. Thank you very much. I know we just came from there, but I've been watching out for that event. Oh, speaking of watching out for things, I got a rare potion. How many doses do I have now? Yep, I just have a good collection of them. 8. Nice. I never use any potions. Oh, you found something else. Another one, up to 9 now. Eventually you'll be finding rarest potions. And I guess we won't be using those either. There's no need to buy potions in this game. You just come across plenty of them as it is. Max says, as expected, there are no signs of bandits. It looks like I'll have an easy time guarding this place. I may have time to read a novel or two. He was given Swordmaster 4. Thank you, says Avon. Sweet. Well, if you have time to read a novel, why are you giving us a novel? I'll just read it really quick. Of course, I'll be making a separate video. Once I have all the Swordmaster books, well, I don't have 2, but I did manage to read it. Restore an old save. Just to read it. I didn't play everything all over again. So I don't have it in this timeline anyway. Swordmaster 4. Wartime novel popular among all ages. Volume 4, Autumn Rain. So I have another alternate title. War Chronicles, Swordsmaster Zamza, Volume 4, Autumn Rain. Rain was beginning to fall on the battlefield. The dry ground soon changed to sludge. That blonde is the Swordsmaster? He's quite handsome, and he's smaller in stature than I thought. A man was observing Zamza from atop a small hill about 120 milos away from the front line. He was very muscular and mountainous. Mountainous. His name was Milligan. He was the leader of the force that Zamza must defeat. Milligan was getting excited while playing with the hilt of his sword. Sounds wrong. His rumors are not lies. His leadership is great. He must have the trust of his troops to have results like this. I'm getting excited while playing with the hilt of his sword. What are you guys thinking? Zamza defeated opponent after opponent as Milligan looked on. His bravery is awesome. I'd like to have a duel with him someday. Be sure not to intervene when that time comes. Arvrahit? Perhaps Milligan's warrior blood superseded that of a leader, just as with Zamza. Milligan was speaking to the dragon, having large body with reddish copper scales and eyes in the color of gold. Its large, sharp eyes turned to Milligan and blinked, as if in acknowledgement. Milligan and Arvrahit had been fighting partners for over 10 years. It looks like we have been defeated today. Milligan's forces were clearly being outmatched by the Red Tribe. This was due to the fierceness of Zamza's forces. It seemed like the autumn rain was giving the final blows to Milligan's forces. But Milligan turned his back with an expression of satisfaction. Even if today ended in defeat, perhaps he can emerge victorious in the end. That was what his face showed. Milligan's wish to meet Zamza alone would become reality in an unexpected manner. And that's that. Stand by, guys. I'll be right back. Okay. Let's see if anyone else has anything new to say. The Adventurer Guild is always quick to respond. But you look awfully young. Are you sure you can do this alone? Does she think we're from the Adventurer Guild? That's the same as before. see. You put frog in your soup. Okay, I don't think there's anyone down that way. Guy's still over here. It's all the same. Finally, just check on these guys. Alright. Let's head back once again. Glad I got that book, though. Speaking of books, hopefully Elenoa can help Rael translate the mysterious red book that we found in the Ice Palace. Didn't mention that. I am very curious myself about what secrets it might hold. There's something about ancient tomes. Ancient tomes and lost arcana. If you know that, what do you call it? Reference. So, west. No, north. You're gonna stop us, right? Yeah. Elenoa says we must go to Koruna as soon as possible. Rael may be in trouble. What if she stops us here as well? See, this isn't the end of the screen. Never mind. We must keep a lookout for ancient scrolls and lost arcana. That'll be this way. They have little balls, like on little green balls. We want to avoid you. Don't make it difficult. It's gotta be. This is a dead end, right? Yeah. Oh. I was heading the right way. Find me rarer. Actually, we only need two more. I told you, rarer, not rare. This song's awesome. It's over. This atmosphere, Elenoa says. Yeah, I know, we got hijinks going on. I feel some strong spell power being generated. Yeah, a man's voice says. Another man, I guess, says, help! Well, the dogs are chasing him? Avon says, what's going on? Miles says, the dogs are acting violently. Let's go find Rael, Elenoa says. He may know the cause of it. Okay. Can Rael be in here? Rael was in here. Rael's not here now. She is. Hiding from the dogs, I guess. The dogs started to act violently all of a sudden. They never acted like that before. You should stay here, too. We can't. We have to find Rael. For some reason, with this kind of music, though, I'm not really afraid of the dogs. and just running around. Is that Rael? Hey guys, that was fast. Hi, Professor Elenoa. Elenoa says, like I thought, that wasn't it. Rael, what in the world is going on? Hehehe, it's all thanks to this book. Rael took out the book that he found at the palace. The Ice Palace. The Eucharist of Life by Durga, or it's called the Book of Life. Oh, that's what they've been looking for, these bandits. Are you serious? Says Avon. Miles says, that's the sorcerer's book Fatima was looking for? Elenoa says, I can't believe it actually existed. Well, unless Rael destroyed it, it still exists. Rael, did you by any chance generate the spell in the book? The one on the first page. That one has the power to employ animals other than humans. I must be a genius. Elenoa says, how could you? You should have never used the ancient spell so carelessly. Rael, let go of the book. It's too dangerous for you to handle. You're always like that. You treat me like a little child and never let me use any strong spells. I will manage to use this Book of Life and prove my ability to everyone. Uh-oh. Can't move yet. Okay. Oh no, says Elenoa. It's going to be a big problem. Mile asks, is that sorcerer's book that dangerous? Either people nowadays can't generate the ancient spells, or if they do, it will accompany great risks. Alright, that's what I read in the sorcerer's school. The ancient spells are forbidden. More than that, it's a legendary book called the Book of Life. I have no clue what kind of danger it will have. Avon asks, if you are afraid, then what are we going to do? The first priority is to catch Rael. We can worry about the rest later. I guess it should be Elenoa saying that. Or maybe not. You're right. Please work together, Avon, Mile. Aren't we three of us gonna work together? The tool shop owner says, hey, you guys, it's too dangerous to go outside. Avon says, we're here to catch the little brat with blonde hair. Is that right? I saw the boy going towards the river. Yeah, he's singing or whistling. Rael, don't move there, Avon yells. Don't move there. Rael says, living of all livings, follow my command in the name of the spirit of the beginning. Pudding is the best treat. Oh, crap. Avon goes, woo! Getting dizzy, I guess. Yeah, spinning like a top, says Rael. And he's still spinning. Ugh. Dizzy, says Mile. Was Mile in there too? I won't tolerate it anymore, says Avon. Bulkin says, remember Bulkin? Where in the world have they gone to? They were stuffing their mouth with fish until just now. Who? Noel says, I don't think they're coming inside the house. We should wait here until things settle down. Well, I guess he meant the dogs. He's gonna call them wolves for some reason. You know what I saw? A boy who was a little bigger than me murmured, and the dog started to act violently. That was cool. I wonder what he did. What's his name in here? Watts? Ugh, I had a terrible experience. I barely made it back here. Let me guess, it involved dogs? I can't believe my dear dogs attacked. What's going on with them? Don't worry, says Elenoa. They'll be back to themselves soon. Indeed, something terrible happened. Why don't you look around my goods and not go outside? No, we have to go outside. He went that way, I guess? Let me check on the old lady. See if she's alright. It's too dangerous to walk outside. The dogs are acting crazy. Come inside the house. By the way, you all look tired. I'll make some tea, so please relax here for a while. I guess. This song starts right up again. What a rude awakening. Oops. I don't need that. Ah, are you already back? What are you talking about? We rested for a while. Elenoa says, Rael, that's enough. We know your ability from the beginning. How much longer do you have to trouble the people in the village? I didn't mean to trouble anybody. Professor Elenoa, will you allow me to use strong spells? Then I'll stop controlling the dogs. That's a different story. It's very important for you to control your spell power. How many times do I have to tell you that I don't need that? It's all right. I'm not going to ask you any more. David says, Hey, Professor, you too honest. Why don't you just let him do whatever for now and teach him a lesson or two after we catch him? Sorry, I'm not flexible. Uh-oh. A man with a mask who doesn't speak. What do you want? Says Rael. Ooh, yeah! A man with a mask stole the Book of Life from Rael. Uh-oh. At least one group of guys after Cabessa, and the other after the Book of Life. A stern female voice says, Hurry up, you guys! A man's voice says, Wait for me, sis! Fatima says, Oh! You must be... Henchman of Borguide? Borgian? Well, these are different... Oh, the man with the mask is not with Fatima. My mission, as ordered by Lord Belias, is to collect the Book of Life. Oh, Lord Belias orders it. Remember him from the first episode, guys? The prelude? Give it to me now! He doesn't speak. Lady. Well, he's got the Book of Life. Dang it, Borgian. I'll lose my position if I can't get the book. Fatima, you again? Says Avon. Elenoa says, What did you do to him? Don't take it wrong, Fatima says. The one who hurt the boy is already gone. He stole the Book of Life. What do you mean? Asks Avon. Why should I tell you? I've already got a headache from thinking about what I'm going to do now. But I will give you a piece of advice. Guia will be in trouble if it's left alone. Good luck on stopping Borgian. Wait, yells Avon. Do you have no idea who Borgian is? Elenoa says, Rael, hang in there. Miles says, let's bring him somewhere to get treated. Well. Elenoa says, I'm very sorry. How can he repay you even though he caused all the trouble? No, no, Mrs. Measle says. It's okay. Luckily, no one was injured. I'm glad his injury is not bad either. Ugh, says Rael. Elenoa says, Rael, are you awake? Hi all. Avon says, don't hi me. Elenoa says, Rael. Why did you do this? Your mischievousness was within a permissible range. Are you sure it was within permissible range? Controlling animals and scaring people are not anything you would normally do. Rael says, Because you were always mean to me. Me? Mean? You are! You don't allow me to use powerful spells and tell me to suppress the spell power and prepare mentally. And Elenoa says, it's because... I'm a full-fledged sorcerer. Don't treat me like a little child. Rael, you are still a child. Being an adult means that you can take responsibility for what you do. You caused a lot of trouble to the villagers. How do you think you can take responsibility for it? Ugh. Elenoa says, sure, your spell is powerful. However, unless you prepare yourself, you'll become someone who will bring calamity. Hey, Rael, how did you feel after you used the Book of Life? I was scared a little. I felt energy coming out of my whole body and not being able to control it. That's why I caused a lot of trouble. Elenoa says, one who obtains a great power is easily led astray into wicked temptations. That's why someone with powerful magic powers must have a stronger mind than the ordinary person. Do you understand what I'm trying to say? Yes. I'm sorry. I guess I troubled many people. Avon says, it's all right as long as you understand. It's important for a man to do what's right after learning a lesson. Someone who did wrong and learned the lesson could become more kind toward others. That's what someone who raised me said a long time ago. Then what I did was the right thing as a result, right? Yeah, like the future great sorcerer. Don't go too far, says Elenoa. Miles says, I think it's enough for now. There are some things that trouble my mind. Elenoa says, where could the Book of Life be? Miles says, and also the word Fatima left. Guia will be in trouble if it's left alone. That's what she said. Avon says, sounds like it's better to make sure. Rael, Professor Elenoa, let's split up for now. Mile and I are going back to Guia in a hurry. Man, these people coming in and out of the group so fast, it's making my head spin. Wait a minute, says Rael. What are you talking about after coming this far together? Mile says, we, as an adventurers, can't leave this dangerous situation alone. You and Professor Elenoa are civilians, so you need to leave this to us. Rael says, it's my fault that the book was stolen. Beside, Ruka is working at the factory in Guia. I have the right to come with you. Well, if it's your fault, it means you shouldn't be allowed. Elenoa says, I have to agree with Rael this time. I can't overlook this situation as a someone who uses sorcery. Please let us come with you. Okay, now you're both coming with us. Make up your mind. Avon says, well, okay, thanks a lot. Miles says, you can feel assured with your spell. What does that mean? Rael says, it's settled. Now, let's now head to Guia. Rael joined the party. Okay. Alright, so that is the four of us. Mrs. Measles says, hi, big guy, can you walk already? I'm fine. Thank you for everything, says Elenoa. No problem. Anyhow, don't force yourself to walk too much. We'll have to walk all the way to Guia. Be careful, big guy. Don't push yourself too hard. I'm sure we just can't get in here. Alright, let's check in with everybody again before we leave. Oh, you were the one who was controlling the dogs. Teach me how, will you? I can't. You will need a book to do it. Genius as I am, I can't control animals without a sorcerer's book. My dad has promised me that he will take me hunting when I get to control dogs well. I guess the only way to make that happen is to train myself step by step. Yeah, I don't think you're gonna have the Book of Life. At least, probably not. They eat fish as if nothing bad had happened. Gee, how can I get mad at them? That's right, says Rael. You can't get mad if the person has no will, ill will. Elenoa said, you had enough ill will in your case. Here, please apologize to him too. Rael explained what he did and apologized. Vulcan says we can't really blame him for what he has already done. Kid, will you promise you will never do that again? Yes, I will never do mischievous things that controls dogs again. I don't really like the sound of that. Well, it's okay. I'll treat you dinner too, kid. Rael received fish which is hot from the grill. Cool! It's hot. Take your time and eat it slowly. Yeah, huff huff. I've known these dogs since they were puppies, but this might be the first time to see them act so violently. What's going on with them? Elenoa says, Rael, you need to apologize. Okay. Rael explained what he did and apologized. You hopeless brat. It was lucky that no one got hurt. You don't have to do it out loud, but please apologize to those dogs, too. I think they're the ones who suffered the most. Yes, I will do that. She's got a point. You poor dogs. I think it's important to have gratitude to not only dogs, but also to all the living things. It should be a will of goddess, too. Translation's a little rough around here. Watts. Is it, by any chance, safe outside? Elenoa says, yes, it's safe now. I'm sorry to trouble you. Here, Rael, you should apologize sincerely. Yeah. Rael explained what he did and apologized. You helpless brat. I was about to die because of you. I was very shocked to get attacked by the dogs which I use every day. You use them? What the hell way to put it? So was hopeless was the first one and helpless brat was the second one, I think. You apologize to these dogs? Woof woof. The incidents have been settled, so I should reopen my business. Please come around the counter. I really don't need anything. Does Rael have the same stuff that we left on him? Yeah, okay. It's my fault the dogs acted so violently since I'm the owner. I'm sorry to have frightened you. No, it's our fault, says Elenoa. Rael, you need to apologize sincerely. Okay. Rael explained what he did and apologized. I see. It was just a mischievous child. I was worried a bit that they got violent because they don't like me much. Haha, I worried about nothing. But how did you control them? I don't think I can even do that well. It's with the Book of Life, sir. Cuckoo? Yeah. That one's actually a bird. They said that the Siam Seal Gang had invaded. Is that why the dogs acted violently? Elenoa says, no, it wasn't the Siam Seal Gang's fault. Rael, you understand? Yes, I do. Rael explained what he did and apologized. I'm relieved that I could find out the cause. Don't cause trouble anymore. I will never do that again. So he apologized to everybody. No, apologize to the statue. So I guess we're heading back to Guia. But that'll be next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.